students, welcome to the next video of integration. In today's video, we are going to see how to integrate when the integral is in the form of 1 upon a plus b sin x dx, or integral 1 upon a plus b cos x dx, or integral 1 upon a sin x plus b cos x plus c dx. Okay, that means numerator is 1 and denominator we are having either sin x or cos x or both sin x cos x. Okay, so this type of sum, in that what we are going to do, we are going to substitute sin x as 2 10 x upon 2 upon 1 plus 10 square x upon 2. Okay, we know that formula is sin 2 theta, that is equal to 2 10 theta upon 1 plus 10 square theta. Okay, so here we substitute sin x as 2 10 x upon 2 upon 1 plus 10 square x upon 2, and cos x, we substitute cos x as 1 minus 10 square x upon 2 upon 1 plus 10 square x upon 2. Okay, so in this is the substitution for sin x and cos x, but actually in sum we'll substitute 10 x upon 2 as t. Okay, so if question is in this type, then we have to substitute 10 x upon 2 as t, and then we will differentiate this 10 x upon 2. So when we differentiate with respect to x, we get derivative of 10 x upon 2 as sec square x upon 2 into coefficient of x, and coefficient of x is 1 upon 2, that is equal to derivative of t is dt upon dx. Okay, so what we will get, sec square x upon 2 upon 2 dx is equal to dt, right? This is 2, huh? In denominator we are having 2. Now this sec square x upon 2, we know that 1 plus 10 square theta is sec square theta. So I am writing this sec square x upon 2 as 1 plus 10 square x upon 2 upon 2 dx equal to dt, right? So that means 1 plus this 10 x upon 2, I have substituted 10 x upon 2 as t. So I am writing this 10 square x upon 2 as t square. So 1 plus t square upon 2 dx is equal to dt. So that means this dx, okay, let me clear this side. So that means this dx is this 1 plus t square upon 2, this will go in right hand side, so it will be 2 upon 1 plus t square dt. Okay, so dx is 2 upon 1 plus t square dt. Okay, so I am substituting 10 x upon 2 as t, dx is 2 upon 1 plus t square dt, then sin x as 2 t upon 1 plus t square, and cos x as 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. So this is the substitution. See here, as you can see here, sin x is 2t upon 1 plus t square, then dx is 2 upon 1 plus t square dt, cos x is 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. Okay, and substitution is, I am substituting 10 x upon 2 as t. Okay, similarly, if question is in the form of integrate 1 upon a plus b sin 2x dx, or integrate 1 upon a plus b cos 2x dx, or integral 1 upon a sin 2x plus b cos 2x plus c dx, okay, then also I will substitute this sin 2x as 2 10x upon 1 plus 10 square x. cos 2x as 1 minus 10 square x upon 1 plus 10 square x. Okay. What I have to put? I have to put 10x as t. Okay. Always substitute the half of this angle. So 2x is given and that's why we are substituting 10x. So 10x as t. Then again differentiating with respect to x. So derivative of 10x is sec square x dx is equal to dt. Now again I am converting the sec square x in 10. So it will be 1 plus 10 square x dx, that is equal to dt. So that will be 1 plus t square into dx equal to dt. So dx is equal to 1 upon 1 plus t square dt. Okay. So the only change when it is a sin 2x or cos 2x is that in this dx will be only 1 upon 1 plus t square dt and the rest of formula will be same, rest of substitution will be same. So sin 2x will be 2t upon 1 plus t square, cos 2t will be 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square and t will be 10x. Okay. So in both the cases, whether it is sin 2x or only sin x, we have to substitute sin as 2t upon 1 plus t square and cos as 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. And dx will be 2 upon 1 plus t square if in question there is a sin x. And dx will be 1 upon 1 plus t square if in the question, if it is given as sin 2x or cos 2x. Okay, depends on the question whether dx is 2 upon 1 plus t square or it is 1 upon 1 plus t square. Now let's see the example. So question is, evaluate integral 1 upon 2 plus 3 cos x. Okay. Now cos x. So cos x is 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. Here cos x is given, so I will substitute dx as 2 upon 1 plus t square dt, right? And t will be 10x upon 2, okay? So by doing all this substitution, we get dx. In place of dx, I am writing 2 upon 1 plus t square dt. Then in denominator, 2 plus 3 cos x. Cos x is 1 minus t square upon 1 plus t square. So that is equal to 2 dt upon 1 plus t square upon 2 plus multiply. I am multiplying this 2 with 1 plus t square. Okay. So 2 into 1 is 2. Then plus 2 into t square is 2t square. Then 3 into this numerator part. So 3 into 1 is 3. Then 3 into minus t square is minus 3t square. Then 1 plus t square and 1 plus t square cancel. So I will get this integral. Okay. So what I am getting? I am getting integral 2 upon 2 plus 2t square plus 3 minus 3t square dt. Okay, I am getting this. So that is equal to integral 2 upon 2 plus 3. So that is equal to 5. Then 2t square minus 3t square. So that is equal to minus t square dt. Okay. Now, can I write this as 2 is a constant? So that will come outside the integral. So 2 into integral 1 upon, now this 5 can be written as root 5 whole square minus t square dt, right? So this is in the form of integral 1 upon a square minus x square dx. And that is equal to 1 upon 2a into log a plus x upon a minus x plus c. Okay, this is the formula. So now this will be, let me clear the screen. So just wait. Form is very simple. You have to just remember the substitution. Okay, so by applying the formula we will get x, in place of x we have to write t, and in place of a we have to write root 5. Okay, so what I will get, I will get I as 2 as it is, then into 1 upon 2a, a means root 5, into log, okay, mod of, now again have to clear this side, so just wait, okay, so log a, in place of a what I have to write, I have to write root 5, so root 5 plus t upon root 5 minus t, okay, plus c, but t is equal to, but t is a 10x upon 2, right? So resubstituting t, this 2 cancel, so by resubstituting t we get 1 upon root 5 into log root 5 plus 10x upon 2 upon root 5 minus 10x upon 2, as you can see here, okay, so 2 cancel, so 1 upon root 5 into log root 5 plus t is a 10x upon 2 upon root 5 minus t, but t is a 10x upon 2 plus c. Okay, so this is the example. Let's see one more example. So here, as you can see, question is evaluate integral 1 upon 4 plus 5 sine 2x dx. Okay, so we have to substitute sine 2x as 2t upon 1 plus t square. No change in sine 2x. Then dx will be 1 upon 1 plus t square dt, and t will be 10x. Okay, so now I will be dt upon 1 plus t square upon 4 plus 5 into 2t upon 1 plus t square. Okay, so that is equal to integral. I am having this 1 upon 1 plus t square, okay, upon 4 plus 5 into 2t upon 1 plus t square. Okay, this is dt. Now have to multiply this 4 with 1 plus t square and this 5 with 2t. So that will be integral dt upon 1 plus t square, and this will be 4 into 1 plus t square. So 4 plus 4t square, then plus 5 into 2t, so 10t upon 1 plus t square. So 1 plus t square, 1 plus t square cancel. So finally what I am getting? I am getting that is equal to integral dt upon 4t square plus 10t plus 4, right? If I take this 4 common, if I take this 4 outside the integral, then it will be 1 upon 4 integral dt upon t square plus 10 upon 4t plus 1, okay? Now, this is nothing but 1 upon quadratic equation. So, to solve this, what I have to do? I have to find the third term, okay? So, t square plus 5 upon 2t plus 1. So, I have to find third term. So, third term will be half into coefficient of t. Coefficient of t is 5 upon 2 whole square. So, that is equal to 5 square, which is 25. Then 4 square, which is 16. So, I have to add this 25 upon 16 and have to subtract this 25 upon 16. Okay, now have to write this t square plus 5 upon 2t plus 25 upon 16 in whole square form. So first I have to take the square root of t. So t, then plus, then square root of 25 upon 16. So that will be a 5 upon 4. So t plus 5 upon 4 the whole square. Then plus 1 minus, next is plus 1 minus 25 upon 16. So 16 minus 25 upon 16, that is equal to minus 9 upon 16. So this can be written as 3 upon 4 the whole square. Okay. Now what I am having? I am having this x square minus a square. So I have to apply that integral 1 upon x square minus a square dx formula. Okay. And that is equal to, that is equal to, let me clear the screen so that I can write here the formula. Okay, so that is equal to 1 upon 2a log x minus a upon x plus a plus c. Okay, so this in place of a, I have to substitute 3 upon 4, and in place of x, I have to substitute t plus 5 upon 4. Okay, so 1 upon 4 as it is into 1 upon 2 into a, a is 3 upon 4 into log x. In place of x, I have to write t plus 5 upon 4 minus a, a is 3 upon 4 upon x, x is t plus 5 upon 4 plus a, a is 3 upon 4. Okay, so this term cancel, right? Then this will be cancel. So 1 upon 2 into 3, so 1 upon 6, then log 4t, then plus 5 minus 3, so plus 2, 4t plus 2 upon 4t plus 8. Okay, now 2 is cancel out, so that is equal to 1 upon 6 into log, in place of t we have to resubstitute this t, so we have to write t as 10x. So 1 upon 6 into log 2 10x plus 1 upon 2 10x plus 4 plus c. Okay, so this is the method of solving this type of sum. With this I am concluding this video. Thank you, students.